Hello everyone, myself Sarthak, C++ trainer. I've been teaching from the last 15 years or 16 years in C++. So let me share my experience with you about the C++, why C++, I have learned C++, why, what I have earned by C++, what exactly C++ is, and I must say you must be already familiar with the C concept, which is a procedural language, not an object-oriented language. C++ is an object-oriented language. By using C++, we can learn many features which is not available in C. And the features like data encapsulation, abstraction, polymorphism, inheritance, but all of above, I must say one thing, C++, being a part of object-oriented programming, provides us the concept of data security, which is not in C at all. As I told you, C is a procedural language, and from where we ends with C, from the same point, we begin with C++. Let me write one small code where I'll tell you how we can switch from structure, means C language to C++, from structure to class. Because C++ language, when we start, we begin writing our code by the implementation of classes. Class, basically, it's nothing. It's just a way to represent a group of similar things or similar objects. I must say, about the class, we can say it never ever exists physically. Never ever occupy some space. In fact, they don't have space. For example, if I talk about vegetable, if I talk about furniture, if I talk about vehicle, all these terms are, I relate with the class. Vehicle is never ever exist physically. If I talk about car, if I talk about motorbike, it's an object of vehicle class. Why it is object? Because these are the things which exist physically, occupy some space, and the things are performed with that only. If I talk about register, marker, pen, which are nothing, are the objects of stationary class. Stationary is in class, and this is the object of stationary class, which exists physically through the marker. It's having some common feature. It's a cylindrical. We just open it. We write something on the whiteboard and all. The things are performed by object itself. So in this way, let me introduce one small code of C++ where we switch from C to C++. I'm writing here small code by using structure programming. If I create a structure, you must be aware, by using a keyword struct, employee, I'm having three elements, employee number, name of 10 elements. Let's say we take only two elements, because about the structure, we say the structure is a group of elements of different data types, so here it is. In order to input data, always we declare a variable of it. And the moment variable is declared, a memory is allotted for its elements. I define one function, input. If I write cin, e dot employee number, c in e dot name. This is absolutely right in case of C. But if I make a minor change, if I replace this struct keyword with another keyword, class, what happened? The moment I write class over there, object-oriented is implemented. In case of object-oriented, the first and major concept is the security of data. which provides the security of data, which is not available in C. Now, what will happen, the moment I write class over there, E dot employee number, E dot name, which were absolutely right in case of C, in case of structure, and the moment I write class over there, compiler will give an error, and the error will be, is not accessible. What does it mean? Is not accessible. I tell you one more thing. If I remove this reference from here, for this compiler will give an error, undefined. So let me discuss these two things. What is the difference between undefined and not accessible? So that you can easily understand the concept of data security. The things, if I'm having, but I can't use, that is hidden. Something is hidden from me. I'm having, but I'm not use. I can't use. Undefined means the things I am not having. If I'm not having, so I can't use, in fact. In this case, employee number, compiler is not able to find out where exactly employee number is. So that's why it's giving an error, undefined. Program, mein kahin par bhi nahin hai. Sorry. For this, is not accessible. If I give the reference e.name, compiler will give an error, is not accessible. Reason behind, compiler has find out ki where exactly name is. But it's a part of the class which is hidden. It is a private by default, so it will give an error, is not accessible, means it is hidden. You can't use it. There is a keyword public. If I write public over here, the moment I write public, you can use it. But if I write public, then there is no sense implementing classes in case of C++. Indirectly, by writing a public, it again becomes a structure. The data head security will, you can get loose. So let it be private. We remove this public keyword from here. Let it be private. Now the question arises, if it is private, you cannot use it here. How will you use it? In that case, I need to put, I need to write the entire function within a class. I need to define it within a class. At that time, it will be a member function of a class. So in short, I must say class is a part of two things, data members and member function. And you know already where structure is a part of only elements, only variables. So we'll include, we'll define this function within a class.